Alright, so we got less than 10 minutes left for the Gearbox PAX East panel showcase. I don't know what they're actually calling it, but yeah, so expectations are mainly just Borderlands 3 for these guys. Borderlands 3, we haven't really seen any official gameplay from it other than concepts, destructible environments like a year or two ago, and stuff like that. They've been kind of pretty in the dark when it comes to this. They've been kind of teasing it for the past like month or two now. But yeah, overall, I have no clue if they're going to really do a good job or not. All they have to do, if they want to win the hearts of their fans, is just show Borderlands 3.
Can you imagine, though, if they did some, or, you know, they Battle Royale, or, God forbid, a mobile game. Can you imagine that each turn, it'd be like the Fallout thing all over again?
Yeah. I mean, they could do a Bethesda and say, oh, you wanted another Fallout game, right? Well, here's Fallout 76. And they could do like an online version of Borderlands. They could do what freaking Fallout 76 did too. Oh my god. It could either be a BR game or it could be something like Fallout 76. And it would just be... Fuck. Fuck. No, you too. I mean, yeah, Gearbox isn't, you know, safe from all that shit. They did Alien Colonial Marines and the latest Duke Nukem, because that was all on them. Even if they didn't previously worked on the core concept of those games, they were in charge of finishing it. And they did they were so lazy when it came to that shit. And not, you know, and their other failure, Battleborn. Battleborn was a complete and utter failure because they were trying to compete with Overwatch and Paladins, and they just got destroyed. So, yeah. But I think it was all, you know, it all comes down to them. You know, it's all their responsibility to keep certain things alive, making sure they're not trying to go into a genre that they could die in, kind of like the hero shooter realm. They know they can't survive in that. They probably can't survive in any battle royale, the genre, as I call it, a game mode. So, I don't fucking know. Microsoft removed Notch from any mentions from Minecraft? He was a creator of Minecraft. This place used to be really nice. What? Yeah. Oh, he got bought out. So he's like a billionaire or something like that now. But Notch created Minecraft. Microsoft bought Minecraft from Notch and his team. I think his team kind of stayed with Microsoft? I don't remember. I forgot the whole story, but that's weird. It's okay to be white tweet. Well, there's nothing wrong with it's okay to be white.
What's
the context? It's like, what's the context of that? Was he doing a rant? Or was he replying to something else? Because context is very crucial for a story.
Like, if it was being really racist, like... Surprise attack!
You try to attack the dragon, but your attacks do nothing. All right, you linked it. The dragon attacks and... Critical hit! Minecraft 4K, fall 2017. That's the first thing I see. Oh. So he was denying white privilege. I mean, he became a million/billionaire. I don't know which one, but.
Tina, you can't start your campaign with a boss fight. Players can't win.
Okay, how about a new boss?
I think people are just. I think everyone's just becoming pansies at this point. We're all becoming
white trash.
I think everyone becomes a little too focused on being politically correct all the time. While I don't always agree with people's tweets, I think that people get too riled up sometimes.
Yeah, someone made an oopsie on the internet.
It's nothing
let
new.
Let them do it. Just
people
let them do
oopsies
it.
People have made on the internet for God knows how long.
Someone fucked up on the internet. It doesn't mean they fucked up in real life, too. It doesn't matter. You don't have to be social justice warriors about it. Just let them keep digging their grave. It's your boy. If it's something actually wrong, then just let them keep doing it. I've seen a lot of Battleborn art there. I'm surprised they didn't try and bury that shit. As I would say, if they're so accepting to Battleborn in their past. Yeah, look at that. Battleborn. I'm kind of wondering if they're going to try and revive Battleborn in some way. Maybe Battleborn will become a BR game. Dear God. It could. Nah, I don't know. I'm just tired of people making one mode video games. BR games are the perfect example of one mode video games. So, I don't know. I mean, at least Fortnite's smart and they're changing it on a monthly basis when it comes to adding things. Like the whole the floor is lava thing. It's kind of smart. It changes up the game significantly. Yeah, free. And most of them are, which is nice. But at the same time, me, when I see a game that only has one thing to play, pretty much that one mode, which is BR, it's like, I'll play it for a day and then I'm done. I haven't played Apex Legends since I played with Jayblader, and I haven't had any need to actually go back to it. Yeah, isn't like PUBG like on what season are they on now? It says on Steam, but they're trying to advertise it heavily on Steam right now. PUBG, what is it, still $30? 40? I don't know. I was like, yeah, that was their downfall. Is that you had to buy the game first, and then they had like battle or survivor passes or something like that after that. It's like that's weak, man. That's so weak. It's the buggiest game out of all BR games that are still alive right now. And at least when it comes to mainstream BR games, like PUBG is like the buggiest one out of them all. Even though they're trying to be the most realistic one, it's still, it's like, man, I had when I was playing PUBG before it officially released, I had little flashbacks of maybe a little bit of SOCOM. Well, yeah, SOCOM. Just the way like you can kind of lean your character, you can kind of go prone and all that, and I thought, oh, can this be like a BR game that kind of feels like a SOCOM? Yeah, SOCOM Soldiers or something like that. That would be fantastic. I would love that. I miss SOCOM. But of course it didn't. Because if it only felt like SOCOM if they improved it. Which, ever since I played PUBG and since it's released and on, they haven't improved it. It's still trashy. So, well, we got less than 30 seconds. I'm crossing my fingers that their biggest announcement isn't freaking... just isn't Battle Royale. You saw those little hints of freaking Half-Life? That was weird. I don't know. I don't trust that. I don't trust the whole,
what would you do if they...
If they released a Half-Life 3, you know how fuck it... The internet would be down. It would crash. You want to see the internet finally die? Release Half-Life 3. Alright, so there's that trailer we saw yesterday. Teaser. Why is this so... The frame rate is shit. It's always like their character designs and all that.
Yeah.
It's always very interesting. See, a lot of people when they were looking at this is like, I'm getting vibes of Battle Royale. I really hope that's not the case. I'm just hoping it's just a nice little... I mean, no one pointed out the flying vehicle.
Yeah.
The flying vehicle would be fun to do in freaking not Battle Royale. In Borderlands 3. Man, flying vehicles? I would love to do that shit. I actually be able to control it.
So there's a lot of stuff going on. It's hard to really know what's actually happening.
Yeah. That's an interesting vehicle, too. I just noticed this an actual vehicle. The actual face, the mass filter. See, this mayhem is coming, but it doesn't mean Battle Royale.
What's up, PAX East?
Please, God, don't fuck up.
Welcome to the stage from Gearbox Software, Paul Sage and Randy Pitchford.
There's Randy.
How's it going, everybody? It's a big moment. Feeling good? Paul's pretty stoked. Paul's creative director on...
How expensive is your overcoat?
I know.
That looks like pure silk, my dude.
We've been working a lot together. There's a lot of people back home that have been working on this thing for a long time, and I'm getting kind of choked up because this is the first few people are going to have of it today. Hey, you're stuck here for an hour. So
an hour.
Stretch it a bit. We're going to show you a bunch of cool stuff. I promise you we're going to finish big.
And, all right. Their biggest announcements at the end.
If they're going to announce Hellfire 3, it's going to be at the end.
That would be so... Watch. Borderlands 3 is in the middle. It's like, what's the big announcement? What? What do you say?
Battle Royale games are fun. That's not what we're making.
Oh, thank God.
You see everyone booed when he said that?
Yeah. Yeah, your fans don't want a Battle Royale game.
Yeah. Okay, so Paul and I are going to talk a little bit about some of the things you saw in the teaser, and then we'll go into a bunch of other stuff, and then we'll finish big. I promise. Do you guys like the teaser?
If you're promising and you're getting giddy, we're never trusting you again, Randy.
Went into making that sculpture are assets created by the folks at Gearbox Software on the next Borderlands game, and I don't know, what do you think?
That's a 3D sculpture, which is crazy.
Yeah, so like you notice there's like lots of little details in it, right? It's the first glimpse at the villains of the game.
That's a lot of stuff.
The cultists. Now, obviously, you want to see some
familiar faces.
Is that the cultists?
That is Tiny Tina.
No, I don't think those are the cult. I think those are the original heroes for Borderlands
exactly
2.
Older now. You know what? I'm going to do something that's actually not on the script. I was talking, there's so many awesome people in the community. You know, we build all this stuff digitally. And, you know, Paul was saying that it's inspiring how when we make stuff digitally, that people in the real world manifest some of the stuff in the real world. And I was earlier talking to some of the cosplayers. Would you guys stand up and, like, show off some of your, like...
There's the cosplayers. Lots of man moxies, huh?
Of course. All the girls gotta be man moxie.
And some of the cosplayers actually like have reached out to me on Twitter, and like I follow some of them. Just hit me up, and I usually like to follow people that do cool stuff. And a couple of them I actually like did NDAs with, and I sent images of some of the things that are going to be in the game so they can kind of get started. And one of you guys actually made something like 3 days. Would you mind coming up here? I want to show this off. Sorry, I can't get you. So this is Casey, right? So some of you guys have tweeted about Casey. Unbelievable, Tiny Tina. Casey may.
Oh, yeah, Tiny Tina's probably going to be a hero.
3 days, so she can bring it to
so you can play as Tiny Tina, hopefully in Borderlands 3.
You guys have no idea how inspiring it is to us as creators to see this stuff in the real world that we can only dream of digitally, right? It's crazy. So let's see what else we got. So obviously, you know, a lot of characters from Borderlands 1 and Borderlands 2, but you'll notice standing on the pile of bandits, dead bandits, that's Vaughn from I love Vaughn, great character. And Vaughn, of course, is from Tales from the Borderlands. And also you can see Aurelia from the pre-sequel, and they're in the game. And let's see what else we got. All those guns, by the way, the whole sculpture is made of guns, and they're all
the psycho midgets.
You can see Tinks. I don't know if you noticed this. Some of you guys have already figured this out, but if you watch, I know some of you are going to scrub through this thing. But if you watch closely, you can notice right there. Actually, zoom in on that.
Enhance.
That's a piece of a shift code.
Shift
code? And that's only 5 digits, and you know, shift codes are 5x5. And some of you guys follow me on Twitter, and you know, I tweet shift codes. And if you have Borderlands 2, you could use that shift code right now, and you'll get some entitlements. There's been a lot of people, like we made community day skins way back in the day. That we
can you guys hear it okay?
Once.
Do I need to turn it up?
To our community day. So like maybe 2,000 people in the entire world ever got them. Well, we've decided to unlock them with these shift codes. So this shift code unlocks one of the community day skins. I believe Zeros, but I might be wrong there. Salvador, thank you. And see, somebody's already ahead of it. Zero's coming, and there's going to be other Easter eggs hidden throughout. In fact, go to the next slide. These are the villains. We'll talk about them more later.
I wonder if these are like Jack's kids.
But
if he had kids.
Actually, this is play the clip.
Because the guy behind her looks like almost a little bit like handsome Jack.
I don't know if you guys noticed. You're probably looking at the villains. But did you notice in the top left corner there was a blinking light? Here, loop it again. Loop it again.
Oh, up there.
Oh.
That's actually Morse code.
And if I totally fucking missed that.
Yeah, it says
top left, blinking
don't
light.
Don't forget to drink your Ovaltine.
What? That's what it says.
There are some fun messages hidden throughout. That's not the only one. You'll find some other messages. Paul, what should we talk about next? Let's see, what do we got next here? Oh yeah. Oh, that's a good point. So Paul wanted me to point out that that's Amara. She's one of the Vault Hunters. You're going to see a lot more of her later. But Paul wanted me to make sure that, like, when you see there's a rack, there's a skag flying on a rack. Like, go back one. Skags will not be mounting racks.
Second bomb
in the game.
No.
That the folks
hey, racks are already worse also, enough. Now we got skags on racks. that sucks.
You get out your magnifying glasses, you can get a look at what she looks like now. But the guys that made the model also got
she
creative.
She has her top hat.
Moxie's bar is in the game, but that's not it. That's some rundown. Like, her bar is awesome. Like, that's cool, but her bar is really cool, and you'll see more of that later.
Bar.
So there are some things in here that might give you some wrong impressions, but we were just having fun. So
we're dicking around with you.
You'll get all that. One other thing, like this thing here. Move ahead one. And I don't know if
they need to change the layering.
That's obviously Handsome Jack's
mask. Their actual cam is in front of the.
We threw that in there because
they layered it wrong.
Handsome Jack is dead. Okay, he's dead. You killed him. He's dead.
He should be dead.
Not even a new U station is going to bring him back at this point. But we're jerks, so we put that in there. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff in there. Feel free to dig through. You'll notice, even in the roses, there's detail. There's guns everywhere. We got Lilith front and center here. There's a new character that we'll introduce later that's hanging out there off to the side. You probably recognize Hammerlock, but on the other side, there's somebody that you'll find out later. Ellie's in there. Marcus is in there. Yeah, Scooter. Sorry, Scooter, you didn't make it. But you guys, this has been a lot of fun.
If you've played any of Tales from the Borderlands, you'll know why.
That was just a tease. We're going to come back. I promise you we're going to finish big. And I'll be back later to talk more about Borderlands, talk more about the next game. Right now, one of the things I wanted to do was take advantage of this moment, because there was a time when Gearbox was a tiny little independent developer, when we had to just scream from the tallest mountain just to get any attention. I remember the first time we came to PAX and they put us in a room that barely fit 200 people, and when it wasn't even full. Look at this, you guys are incredible. Like, holy crap, thank you guys. Thank you guys for coming.
Because we were promised Borderlands 3. I want that mask, though.
When we founded Bandit Gearbox mask. Software, cool. My vision was that this isn't a means to an end. Like, back then, there wasn't really any money in games. We just wanted to create entertainment. And we knew that interactive entertainment was the most exciting new medium that our species had ever created. The first time in the species history, you can actually interact with your content. And this is awesome. So we dove in, and we just want to entertain the world. And now that we kind of have a voice, we created a group that can help us amplify and help other games reach the market. So we've been working with some independent developers, and we have some cool things we want to show you. So I think I talked about everything you wanted to talk about. All right. So Edgewise when Paul's in the house. But now I think let's introduce Steve Gibson of Gearbox Publishing. You ready, Steve?
And publishing comes in. Yeah. Cares about publishing.
Hey, everybody. I'm Steve Gibson. I have had the honor of leading the charge of creating the Gearbox Publishing Group. We've been at this for a few years. And while Randy and all those guys have been making a Borderlands game, we built a worldwide publisher. So we have been fortunate enough to work with a lot of people. You'll see behind me here, we started off with Homeworld. And that was an honor for us to get that franchise and bring it back to people. I imagine many of you guys here have gotten to play that when we did the remaster. And we're building a future for that franchise, and we're really excited to share that with you guys in the future. We're working on a bunch of other games too, but I wanted to share with you, here's the guys we've met up with and worked with so far, and we want you to take a look what they've done. You see We Happy Few very recently. Compulsion Oof. Games was amazing at work. Oof. We're going to talk a little more about what they have in a bit. The guys at Tiny Build with Hello Neighbor, we've helped those guys sell millions of copies around the world, and it was an honor to work with Tiny Build.
They work with Tiny Build? Okay.
A moment for us working with them. Bulletstorm, the guys at People Can Fly. That is an amazing game. The fact that we got to work with People Can Fly, the fact that we got to
put... still after a bit, though.
Home, probably I was always been in Bulletstorm, into that game was a great moment for us. We got to work with guys that who made Banner Saga was still at Games.
I still need to play that.
A lot of you guys really should check that out. It's a nice little small game. We helped them bring it to Switch. You will love it. Check it out. Epic Games, you may have heard of them.
A little too much lately.
We managed to work with them on bringing Fortnite to Save the World to retail not too long ago. Those guys have been amazing. Of course, they also power the technology for the Unreal Engine that we use for Borderlands. There's been a lot of great things that we've been working on, and we want to share a few more things with you guys here today. So let's flip on to a couple more games. So I have some stuff to share with you guys about Compulsion Games, People Can Fly, and Tiny Build, what they're up to. First, we're finally launching the new DLC next week.
Why are you launching DLC when it's not even fixed?
They came from below. We're going to share with you guys a whole lot more details in just a few days. It's going to be launching on all the platforms, including PlayStation. And you will have a trailer and all the
information. I don't think anyone's really excited about any We Happy Few announcements.
Free for you guys to download. It'll come out at all the places. Next for you guys, I got something for you.
Oh. Oh, Bulletstorm.
Bulletstorm.
On Switch. Not... excited about
Man,
this either.
I cannot believe this is happening. This is crazy. All right, the folks at Nintendo have been so supportive.
I see ya.
This is an amazing, well-performing game.
Okay.
We are really just super close. Our production guys were very nervous about us putting out a launch date. I'm very bullish about it being early summer. But we have one more milestone to go, and then we'll tell you guys the launch date. It is right around the corner. It's just an all-encompassing, includes all the DLC and Duke. You don't have to buy it separately. And that will be coming out on Switch, and it plays amazing.
I mean, the very first build at least Switch is getting more games, even if they're ports.
We're shocked with. The guys at People Can Fly and the guys at Dragon Lake have killed it on this, and we're excited to share with you guys in the near future. All right, I've got another one for you guys, Tiny Build. I'm sure some of you guys are familiar with them. They've worked on some crazy things like Cluster Truck.
Cluster Truck.
And Hello
That's
Neighbor.
A fun-ass game.
I wanted to share with you guys today another game that they're working on. They're announcing their launch date here with us today. Take a look.
Bro?
Dad used to bring us food home.
Oh, is this Pathology 2? Or is it not? No, it's not.
And I will get a dog. Teach it to be a tiger. I'll call it Grumpy.
The game about kids.
Happily ever after.
Looks like they're in a really fucked up world.
And horribly ever before.
This is giving me Rule of Rose vibes. Has anyone played Rule of Rose? This is giving me Rule of Rose vibes. This is weird.
The plague bringer is here, walking around. Pit-a-pat, pit-a-pat, oh pit-a-pat. Three coffin bears, two mice, and a bat. I didn't do it. Don't look at me like that.
Oh, it is. Yeah, it is Pathologic 2. That's what I thought it was. You don't play as a kid in that one, though. Unless you do. Somewhere what around the game.
All right.
It's Pathologic.
Now it's on to some new partners. This is the moment.
I thought it was Pathologic 2 at first, but I was like, guys, is it Tiny Build?
We partnered with a few folks. Now, as
I know.
Randy was
saying, I was like, where'd it go?
We have been so fortunate at Gearbox.
Like,
to
you
have
can take it at work, I guess.
What we're doing. And it is our honor to share with you guys, you know, all these great games that we want to make sure that you get to take a look at as well. Now, first of all, System Era.
Love you too.
This is a fantastic game. Some of you guys are probably aware of it. We don't think enough people
I can't
are.
See it.
So we want to make sure, and we're
what
going to
do
our part, and we're announcing a partnership with System Era. We're going to help System Era bring Astroneer to more places around the world, and we'll have more details on that soon. Thank you, System Era, for partnering with us. You're going to hear a lot more about that. All right.
What's above him?
Next.
this is not a Justin Roiland game.
Yeah.
How do you explain
so
this
the,
one?
The guys at Squanch Games, we met up with them a few
times. Can you, like, show what's on the screen?
They have the most bizarre title that is just funny as hell. And a lot of you guys are probably familiar with Justin and his work on Rick and Morty. And, yeah. So spent some time with those guys at the studio. Definitely recognized the first time I met Justin. I absolutely recognized him, promise. It was not awkward. And when we got to spend the time with them together and they shared with us their passion for the game and just how freaking weird this thing is, we were excited that the guys at Squanch and honestly the guys at Sony as well were happy to work with us on this. We wanted you guys to check this out. They're just now announcing their launch date as well.
His mic keeps moving on his head. It's bugging me.
This bull. Back to you in the studio, Chuck. You. I don't give a. Sorry about that, folks. Clearly, lots of.
Yep, this is a Justin Roiland game.
I wanted divorce too, and you're keeping the kids because you don't respect me. You push me, and you push me.
We are the abstainers.
Oh, that's what the abstainers look like.
Why can't you just respect that I don't want to rotate my chair? I don't want to be jiggling around.
It looks just like the guy who's got the dogs in his eyes causing all this trouble.
Shut the f*** up, Trover. No one needs to hear your commentary about everything. I'm gonna eat some piss, drink some piss.
All right, and that's how we do it. Let's go.
We must find the Crystal of Ithocles.
Partner, we gotta find the Crystal of Ithocles.
I have the Crystal of Ithocles right here.
You son of...
You stupid piece of...
Do you have to play it in VR?
So I need you to shut the fuck up and do what the fuck I tell you to do.
I really hope you don't have to just play it in VR. It's exclusively on PS4 and PlayStation VR, so I don't know.
All right. All right, and now for the last one.
Because I want to play a Justin Roiland game, but they've all been on VR lately.
Yeah. There's a few guys who might know them. In fact, let me show you the trailer first. You guys get a feel of what these guys have been working on. Check this out.
Color palette is pretty interesting so far. Oh, Risk of Rain 2? Oh, shit. First one was pretty interesting. This is a 3D Risk of Rain. That's interesting. Yep, dying's always a thing in Risk of Rain, man. Is this multiplayer? Oh shit! Risk of Rain multiplayer. That's gonna be interesting. Art style is interesting as well. It's a very pastel look to it. The way you die in this game is like just ragdoll. No animation. You can see this being fun. I would love to play this with you guys if it turns out well. It has that weird vibe of like Breath of the Wild mixed with Earth Defense Force. That's like the crossover. Earth Defense Force and Breath of the Wild. That's what it feels like.
This one is so exciting for me. This is a huge day for all of us.
I do need to play.
Excited to share it with Paul.
More of the first
and his
one.
Team. In fact, hey, Paul, you ready? I want you guys to welcome Paul. Paul here is working with a very small team to make Risk of Rain 2.
How's it going? So,
and I armpit.
Said, I'm Paul. I'm from Hopu Games. The team and I have been working on Risk of Rain 2 for about 3 years now. At its core, it's a co-op, roguelike, third-person action game. When we first started looking for publishing partners for Risk of Rain 2, Gearbox stood out to us because they understand the kind of game we're making. We both love co-op games, shooters, games with tons of awesome loot. So we're super excited to be working with them. I think also we want to make sure that the fans of Risk of Rain understand and expect the game and kind of know what they're getting into. So we want to make sure that the community's heard and the feedback is there. So with that being said, I'm very excited to announce that Risk of Rain 2 is available on Steam in early access today.
Steam! Not just Epic.
Yeah. So check the game out.
So it's early access right now.
To hear about future content updates, what we're working on. Tell us what's great about the game, maybe what's not so great. We'd love to hear your feedback.
I'll put it on my wish list.
Game and on Discord. Thanks a lot, guys.
I'm interested.
1 second.
Oh boy.
So we're helping Paul out in all the ways that you would hope, helping him bring him to additional platforms, getting the word out about how great and amazing this game is. We are so passionate about what he's building. Randy's probably going to come out here and talk about it as well.
Yeah, he looks so nervous right now.
For all this. Let's go get your game out there on the world. Yeah. But thanks, everybody. Hey, Randy, come on out.
Thanks, guys.
All right.
Dude.
Thank you.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, dude.
It was actually my family at the last PAX in Seattle that where they were demoing Risk of Rain 2, and they discovered it and were playing the game, and you know, texting me like, "Dude, you got to check this out." And I looked at everything online and talked them into letting me play a build. And that game is insane, you guys. Like, you have no idea. Like, there are like three people at Hopu, three developers. And I was playing Risk of Rain 2, and with the co-op gameplay and the shooting and the looting, I thought, holy shit, like, this is exactly the game that Gearbox would make if instead of 450 people, we only had a team of, like, 25. And they're three people! So I'm just stoked about that. Oh, here's another thing, too, that I'm supposed to tell you about. Apparently, our buddies up at Valve that run the Steam platform, we're able to do an exclusive deal with them where if you get Risk of Rain 2 within the next few days, you get a free copy that you can gift to a friend.
Oh!
And the Steam guy, yeah.
It's tempting. Cool. Not falling for that trick.
And we want you to play co-op.
It's tempting,
so
though.
The Steam guys had to create a special path so that you can get, when you buy it, you'll get the
tools. That's tempting.
Gift that to anybody on your Steam.
I would love to play it with you guys, but man.
So that's awesome.
I don't have the money. That's another thing. I don't have the money.
Let's talk about some other stuff. Actually, I was realizing, like, a lot of you guys, why are you here? There's like over 3,000 people in this room. Why are you here? Like, it's Thursday. Like, shouldn't you be at school or work or something? Or
buy two copies, Megan. Buy two copies.
Like, celebrating things. Like, does anybody have like a birthday that just happened like within the last week, or have a birthday coming up the next week? Any birthdays?
My birthday is in October.
Your birthday's tomorrow. Your birthday's today.
Yay! Happy birthday, you people in the crowd and
Danny,
in the stream,
do you come
maybe.
Up and help me? Oh, I got a gift for you. Your birthday's tomorrow. Your birthday. Would you help me too? Can I give you a gift?
Oh.
I got a gift for you guys.
Risk of Rain gifts.
Can one of the enforcers help them get back here so they don't die climbing up on the stage? There's no stage. Yeah, so go to. They'll help you up. So I brought a couple of gifts. Here, let me get this set up.
Hello. What's in the box? What's in the box?
Thank you. Oh, yeah, there's a mark. Perfect. Thanks.
There's a mark?
I just realized something. I only have one wrapped gift.
You're going to have to fight it out.
It's okay. We'll fix this. We'll fix
fight
this.
To the death for the gift.
What's your name?
Darshel,
nice to meet you. And what's your name?
Danny,
nice to meet you, too. Darshel, would you mind coming over here? This is your gift.
Those...
And are you
leather pants, man.
Would you mind helping me out for a few minutes? I want you to hold this. I don't have a gift for him, so I'm gonna do something else. But if you hold on to that, I'll ask you to help us with what we're doing over here in a second. Danny, right? You know what I can do? Hey, boy, do you have the box of more? Can you climb
the box of more?
This is my son.
Wait, Randy has a son?
He's also... Can you give him a copy? Yeah. So what he's got is a box of a new tabletop game, which is literally the first tabletop game that's ever been made with the Borderlands franchise. And it's
tabletop Borderlands?
This robot tea party.
Yeah, oh! They made a freaking tabletop game out of Tiny Tina's shit.
He's Randy 3. I'm not that vain. If I was the first, I probably wouldn't have done it, but I'm just keeping it going. You know? But I think he's actually going to be, there's a booth where this game, can you rip that open actually? There's a box there, I'll give you a fresh one. We're going to destroy that one because I want to show people what's up. There's a booth on the floor if you want to pick one up. It's like 20 bucks. It's booth 2411. Yeah, open it up. My kid will actually be there, and his name's Randy Pitchford, so he'll be helping to sell games. So if you want, you can go pick one up, and you can
Wait,
get it signed by
Randy.
Wait,
you name your kid after you? So there's two Randy Pitchfords?
Okay. Actually, let's use this table here. What do we got? Get those out. Let me show you. So here's the instructions. This is actually the first, like, these just got shipped here. This game isn't even out yet, so it's kind of like a PAX East exclusive. Let's see. Objective. Be the first to finish your claptrap by building two arms, a hat, and a wheel of a single claptrap. Oh, this is cute. Like, Tiny Tina's, like, written. She's, like, scribbled over the rules. She's, I don't know if you can see that, but she's written. It's funny. Yeah, branding. Yeah, yeah. Can you open the cards up? So the card game, I'll help you.
Jeez.
I'm good with cards. Okay, so here, hold that. Oh, you know what else? You guys want to buy this because under here, there's a shift code.
It's another shift code?
It's like an Easter egg. Okay, we'll come back to that. So what you'll get is you first pick a claptrap. Like there's standard claptrap, like gentleman claptrap, there's sheriff, pirate, wizard, and you're going to build your claptrap. And so you'll get a hand of cards, and there's all kinds of different cards like... okay, so this is the regular claptrap. He's got his birthday hat.
I bet.
There's this is a wizard arm, right? So you take all these parts. There's the sheriff wheels, sheriff hat, gentleman claptrap hat, wizard hat, and so on. Oh, this is one of the special cards. This is called Take a Spin. So with Take a Spin, you get to pick the next seven cards, look at them, pick the one you like, and then you can immediately put it on your robot. You can also put the wrong parts on other robots, so you can screw your neighbors. There's usually on the bottom, there's ways to fix that. Yeah, like right here, swipe. Here, you can hold those. Swipe, take a card at random from another player's hand. Party foul. This is Tina's party foul. Sometimes you need to interrupt. Somebody's going to make the winning move. You can block them. Stop a card from being played. The sheriff arm. Oh, bring the pain. So punch. This is Brick's punch. He can punch like the legs off a claptrap, which I've always wanted to see happen. New you. If everybody's just been dogpiling on you and just completely screwed your robot up, you can reset it. You can knock all the pieces off and get a new you. Wild. Digistruct. The Digistruct card is. All the Digistruct cards are wild, so you can apply it even if it doesn't match your claptrap. Dumpster Dive, that's Crazy Earl. You can go through the discard pile and pick whatever card you want. And Pirate Hat, there's a bunch of these. But I just realized something. I have cards. And I'm a magician. Should we do a trick with these?
He does magic.
Yeah? Oh, you want to do a trick with me? Oh, yeah. Okay, so here's what we'll do. I'm going to spread these out.
Hey, Generaldo.
Okay, so you'll look at these and just kind of like, I want you to just, it doesn't actually matter what card you're going to pick because we're not going to do like, I'm going to figure out what your card is. But if you like one, just touch it, slide it out. Like I just picked this one. So I picked Gentleman Claptrap Arm, right? So it's got the monocle. So we'll pick it out, we'll look at it, and then I'm going to get a pen out and you're going to sign your card. So it's not. I don't need to know. We'll all know what the card is, but yours will be the only one in the world that looks like it because it's going to get signed. Okay. So I'm going to put that one on top. So don't go to the top. Just anywhere in the middle. Touch any card you want. That one. Okay. Hold on. That's the card. Okay. Let me get these together, and show everybody what it is.
He just wants to show off his magic skills now.
This is pirate. This is the pirate pirate claptrap arms. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you where to sign. I'm like a little X there. And then so sign it on the line.
Okay. I have the handwriting of a second grader.
Oh, that's good. let's see, we don't need that. And do you usually sign your name like this?
Yeah.
Exactly like that?
Yeah.
Like on checks? Credit card receipts?
Yeah.
Okay, let's show everybody. Selfie. This is what Danny Signature looks like. All right.
All you need is a social security number and you're good to go.
You stay there. I want you to look at that. If you recognize it again, okay? Help me out. We'll get the deck out. We're gonna do something impossible. Here, I'm gonna cut right here, drop it in, face down, right? Put it back in there. It's lost in the deck. We're gonna shuffle it.
In the middle.
We're gonna shuffle it. I want you to think of a number. Don't say it yet.
Not yet. They might be saying something about it.
Between 1 and 50.
Later on.
A random number. Okay, and we didn't work anything out before.
They've been showing off other projects, Generaldo.
I had no idea you were even coming up. Okay. Random number. In fact, if you want, you could even ask somebody from the crowd, but or you could pick yourself. You decide. 1 in 50, we're going to need a number.
47. And they showed off Pagelogic 2.
47. 47, you guys.
Showed off a bunch of indie games. Justin Roiland game.
We can do 47, but we're going to count down.
Risk of Rain 2, which if you buy a copy of Risk of Rain 2 right now, you get a free copy to gift to someone, which is kind of cool.
It's no big deal. It's up to you.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
So we're going to go through 47. It's cool. We can do it. I'm a magician, you guys.
You have Risk of Rain Fridays, guys.
I'm sorry. She doesn't want to change her mind. Count one card face
three
down.
Three coffees.
Face down on the table. Yeah.
Do one. We have six people to play Risk of Rain now?
Three.
I only need like two.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, stop! It was 47, right? Let's get these out of the way. That is the 47th card. Put it onto the table.
Face down.
Let's let it build. I'll take those. That's the 47th card.
Is this scripted?
Show the card. Show him the card. It does not have your signatures. You guys, this is supposed to happen. Because I asked her what number to pick. And you've been holding that box, that gift wrap box, from the beginning.
Watch. His card is in the gift wrap.
Don't get ahead of me. Open it up. Rip the packaging off, if you can. It's really professionally sealed.
Is it in the box?
Yeah. Get the cards out. You gotta open those too. They're also, here, sure. You can get rid of the claptrap cards.
So where's the card that she had?
So let's just get rid of those. Okay, now.
She put it somewhere. Where is it?
I'm gonna touch them. Count into my hands. 47.
Oh, God. Do it faster than that guy.
Go ahead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, stop! Take that card. Don't look at it. Hold it against your chest. That is the 47th card. Give me the rest of these. Give me the rest of these. She has the 47th card.
Watch, it doesn't work or something like
that. That card was sealed with the rest of these cards in plastic in a box, sealed in plastic, wrapped as her birthday present. He signed a card. It's gone. You've got a card. You don't believe it, do you? Did you look? Did you look?
He's retiring to be a magician. That's his next career goal.
A miracle, you guys! A miracle!
A miracle would be Borderlands 3 actually being announced now.
Thank you so much. You did a great job. You know what? I screwed up both your games, so let's get you some fresh copies. Happy birthday, Danny. Happy birthday, Darshell. Darshell and Danny! Thank you, guys. And they'll help you not die on your way back. Cheers. And maybe Colin wants to give these away later. So if you want to pick that game up, it's pretty fun. It's now my my warm-up game for my board game group. It's actually really legit. And we'll be over. I'll probably be around, too, if you want to bump into me. I'll be happy to sign it or whatever. But that's it. We're done. That's the new Borderlands game.
Don't you dare. This hasn't been an hour yet, bitch.
You're going to kill me. I'm not surviving this day.
What am I getting that card game, though?
Let's get on. We've got actually a lot of great Borderlands stuff to talk about. What are we doing next? Oh, do I introduce him? We'll have Voice of God do it.
It's okay, Randy. Please welcome to the stage Senior Community Manager Colin Sweet and a gaggle of Gearboxers.
Come on, you guys. I'll be back.
Missed a piece of plastic.
How's it going, everybody?
Hi.
Man, we honestly would not be here today if it wasn't for you, our community. The love and support that you guys have shown us over the years, whether it's through your amazing cosplay, your social media messages, even your handwritten letters, each of these validate our desire within Gearbox to entertain the world. I'd like to take this opportunity to quickly introduce you to some of my amazing colleagues up here on stage.
Hi, my name is Mario Rodriguez. I'm an associate producer at Gearbox Software working on Borderlands 2 VR.
Hey, I'm Anthony Nicholson. I'm a project producer, so I kind of work on all with all the departments and a lot of these cool people up here.
Battleborn!
Yeah!
Woo! Hey, what's up?
Dead game, yeah! Battleborn, yeah!
Basically draw cool stuff all day.
Hi everyone, I'm Kate Pitstick and I'm a mission designer at Gearbox Software.
Hi everyone, I'm Kayla Belmore. I am a pipeline producer and I work on content creation at Gearbox Software.
Now guys, we've got a lot to go over with you today, but I'd like to just kind of point out that really today just marks the very beginning for the year of Borderlands. We've got several more exciting announcements for you guys throughout the months to come. So that being said, we encourage you to not only follow our current channels, but also our brand new Discord. There, you'll be able to find things like community skins, codes, the whole nine yards, as well as take part in live AMA opportunities with leadership within Gearbox, including that of Randy Pitchford himself. In fact, we can even give away some physical products today. I mean, we've got apparently some more of this brand new board game that Randy just did his magic trick with. So throughout the entirety of this weekend, we'll start kicking that off right away. You know, one of the things that we really wanted to do with this Discord is to kind of bridge that gap between us as a developer and you guys as our community. So I think probably to kick things off, we'll probably talk about, you know,
Discord
what
rules.
Your experience was in terms of listening to our community and their feedback. You want to talk a little bit more on that?
Sure. So I guess some of you have played the game.
I'm cool. Sure.
So we launched
not the VR version.
And it was very positive feedback, but we got some tweets and comments like these. So we got right back to work as soon as we saw that. A lot of you wanted it. And so we worked really hard to bring it out, and earlier this month, we actually released a free update that introduced AIM Controller in Borderlands 2 VR. We are very happy to do that.
That looks so weird.
Now, we hear you want more. So we see these kinds of tweets. So we're happy to announce that our team is continuing to work on the game, and we have one more update coming up later this summer that will introduce all of the DLC for Borderlands 2 to Borderlands 2 VR. This will be a free update this summer.
Now, we actually have some more information with VR, but we'll hold that off for a later date and time. But actually, you know, before we talk about some of the other messages that you guys have read yourselves, why don't we just kick things off with a video to start?
Wake up, Vault Hunter. I'll explain everything soon, but know this. You're alive for a reason, and I am here to help you. Help you witness these world premieres.
World premiere. Next shot.
You want to hear a story, huh?
Oh. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. It's not just audio.
Wake up.
So, you want to hear a story, huh?
Oh, shit. I knew it was going to be a shit show, but fuck. Oh, no. Are we not going to get the announcement? What's wrong with the file? It's under MP4-3. We fucked up the coding. Third time's the charm, I guess. Ooh, I wish they had it in better frame rate, man. Pre-sequel. Nah, I never cared about it. Well, that's Borderlands. Man, the Handsome Jack collection's been out for a long time. What else? Remastered? So they remastered the Handsome Jack collection? With bonus materials, stuff like that. So many frame rate issues when it comes to your presentation. It's like, this isn't Borderlands 3 though. It's like, I already have all these games though. I'm gonna buy a remaster. If you have it on PC, you don't really need to remaster it.
Next one's ready to play. Yeah.
I can hear you on the mic, sir.
Hey, sorry about the technical difficulties. We were going to have our angel, Brittany, introduce 4K up-res versions of Borderlands and Borderlands A Handsome Collection, including Borderlands 2 and Borderlands The Pre-Sequel. And you just saw the Handsome Collection video. Thanks for coming out, Brittany. I'm sorry that this is Brittany. This is our angel. This is Guardian Angel. So welcome her. Can we play? Can we do it again? Can we do it again? Do you want to look at the camera and maybe we'll do it live this time? Can we do it live with the? Yeah, 1 second. Sorry about this, you guys. I'm really nervous because we have another video that I really want to make sure it's perfect. How we doing?
Oh, man.
Are we good? Okay, I'm going to get out of here. We'll have the guardian angel kick it off.
Wake up, Vault Hunter. I'll explain everything soon, but know this. You're
alone. Are you going to show it again? And I've just seen it.
I'm here to help you. Help you witness these world premieres.
Okay. Maybe it's world premieres.
Jesus fucking Christ. Don't use that fucking player, dude. Jesus.
You won.
Windows Media Player of all fucking things. You could have had a YouTube video that you didn't publish and it would play better. Fucking hell. Oh my god.
All right, okay. Let's welcome all the devs back to the stage to talk about this next game.
Jesus.
Okay, so they're going to make sure this video works before we do the next thing. What you would have seen was an awesome 4K remastered up-res edition of the original Borderlands. Which is coming.
Oh, they're remastering the original Borderlands?
And it's
hopefully
awesome.
It plays a little better.
Like, we didn't just go in and
touch up the graphics,
render it in 4K and port it to the new platforms. We actually did stuff. We actually did, like, one of the
things
we did, we never supported, we didn't have Shift for Borderlands 1, so there was no support for things like Shift codes. But I think that's my favorite thing about the remaster, the Game of the Year edition of Borderlands 1, is now there's Shift codes. So I can tweet golden keys at you guys all day for Borderlands 1. Do you have a mic? Kayla, what's your favorite thing in the remastered version?
Borderlands 1 is going to be getting real heads and skins.
Oh, cool, yeah. Remember, we just had color shifts on the characters, right? Kate, what do you dig?
Well, starting as a level designer in the industry, one of the things that's important to me is navigation. So
yeah.
Borderlands 1 will have the minimap on screen now.
Oh, that's cool.
To help you get around.
Oh, yeah, that's Borderlands right. 1 didn't have a minimap.
Do you like this impromptu way of dealing with what you didn't see in the trailer? Mario, what do you like about...
I hear people like co-op, so Borderlands 1 will go from 2 players to 4 players.
4 players?
Oh, yeah.
Four-player split screen, one console. Holy shit. Anthony, what do you think? What do you dig?
I mean, it's remastered, so we get to play it on Xbox One and PS4 now.
Well, this is separate, I think.
Yes.
I don't know if it's going to be in the handsome collection.
New platforms. Amanda, you got a mic. What do you think?
Well, I'm really stoked to see it and play it in 4K to see all the awesome art that inspired me to kind of want to work at Gearbox. Just try to imagine it.
4K.
Beautiful 4K.
They were trying to show it to you in 4K, and it destroyed the laptop, apparently. So, it's awesome. It's coming out kind of soon, like immediately.
Immediately, like today?
We've actually remastered some things. We've had a lot of fun with the boss fight at the very end of the game. There's a hell of a lot of loot. I think you got.
Yeah, the boss fight in Borderlands 1 was very underwhelming.
A summary of the quality of life improvements that are in the game. Yeah. Thank you, guys. What else do we have to say about it? What's the next slide? We have Borderlands 2. Borderlands is a pre-sequel. Also refreshed, enhanced for 4K, remastered. And what does this mean? This means that all three of these things are available. And I believe that everyone that came to visit us here today is getting them for free. Is that what you're doing?
Oh, so if you already have it, you get it for free. Okay. That's so cool.
So how How are they giving them out? I guess they have coupons. So are they doing coupons. It on the way out? Somebody, how are we doing this? Oh, you already have it. Spoilers. So thanks for coming, you guys. Let's go over what we've learned. There's a new Borderlands game coming. We got some cool things the publishing's doing. There's a board game for our friends Nerdvana Games.
The space initially left blank.
That's about it, right?
Is it time?
I think it's time.
Come on.
Are you guys ready?
Come on. I'll hide the webcam just for this.
I gotta do this first. I gotta show you guys something first. You might like it.
Come on.
This was a gift that was waiting for me when I checked into the hotel that they made for me. I guess I'll just do this.
Oh. It's confirmed. It's not. It doesn't say BR on it. Jesus, that is tacky as shit, but thank God it's Borderlands 3. Well, if it has a BR mode, hopefully it doesn't actually hurt the base game of it. I don't care if it has a mode of BR, as long as it has Borderlands 3 and you can just play Borderlands 3 and forget about BR. I don't give a shit. If it's strictly BR, fuck that.
So that's it. No, that's not it. That's not it. What is... You want to do it?
Randy, I think there was only one thing people wanted to hear me talk about today.
That's right.
So I'd like to ask that my friends at Gearbox Quebec and at Gearbox Frisco help me out.
Hopefully you don't have a video player trailer. World premiere. Take a shot, guys. Frame rate. Man, this frame rate, I'm not liking the frame rate though. I know it's the video player, but this hurts the eyes though. It looks good, art-wise. There's four people there. Four player co-op. And she's muscular, holy shit. I'm playing as her, dibs. Hey, look at that new vehicle. Oh, what the fuck is that? Alright, got some new creatures. That's nice. Brick set.
course, the loot. Oh, running gun.
Mech. Hey, it looks like a Borderlands game, guys. There's Claptrap. Can't have a Borderlands game without Claptrap.
Okay.
As long as there are characters that didn't die in the franchise. So if a character died in, like, you know, Borderlands, they're dead. Rip Scooter.
Oh my god. Okay, there was some technical problem with that. It was jittery. They tell me they fixed it. Should we run it again?
Oh, can we actually see it not in jittery form?
We'll do it one more time.
Oh, well, I'm gonna stay here now. It's still jittery. I don't want to rewatch this jittery again. It hurts the eyes. It's still jittery. Stop using that fucking video player. Jesus. You said you fixed it.
Help me out, you guys.
You're killing me, man.
I love
killing me, Smalls.
Come on. We should have brought our own equipment, right? Can we do it, you guys?
Ooh, that was a jab at PAX.
They're amazing. It's just there's a lot to manage here, and it's 4K, and it's kind of new. How are we feeling? Can we do this? They said they'll wait.
I don't know if I'll wait. I need to get shit done today.
So how's it going?
Yeah, who uses Windows Media to present a fucking trailer?
Can we, maybe we kill the middle screen, because this is some weird stuff. It's not even 4K, and just do it on the two side screens. Can we make, will that, maybe there's a chance there? I don't know.
Ah, for Christ's sakes.
You'll understand.
He's probably getting really mad now.
I've been working on this game for 5 years, and
5 years is a long fucking time.
So much of themselves, it's obscene the amount of personal effort that goes into a Borderlands game, and our deepest wish is to just do whatever we can to make
it work. Upload it on YouTube.
We know how important.
I'll share it on Discord.
We know how important it is to us, and I really would love to see this thing shown in the way it's meant to be shown. So
YouTube, upload it to YouTube. That's all you have to do. Watch, it's gonna be jittery as fuck again. Oh, thank you. I'll hide myself one more time. That way you can see everything. Every little detail. Watch, this starts getting jittery again. Ooh, the bad guys look interesting. She's looking good. There we go. No more jittery. Yay! Yeah, I was kind of getting mad at the freaking the tech people, man. Stop using the fucking media player. Yeah, I'm claiming her. Unless there's a character that looks a little bit better in her. I might just claim her. I mean, we could probably all play as her. Doesn't really matter. She looks like... No, she does not look like Lara. Wait. Oh, hey, yeah, they're bringing back these characters. Oh, yay. He's going to be playing as Tiny Tina. Unless she is playable. I don't know if she is playable. It seems like they have a good amount of heroes to play, of Vault Hunters to play as. So I don't know. We'll see when it comes out. We'll see who plays who. Then I'll just kind of choose the balance. I want to know what that creature is. Tiny Tina's all grown up. It kind of does look like Marcus from Gears of War. it has a nice little mustache, but he has like the do-rag and everything. Alright, we're able to see it not so janky, so that pleases me. Wee-hoo!
Thank you guys! We'll see you soon! I'll see you around!
Alright, I think that is it for the showcase. We're good to go. Ah, man. So, final opinions about that? They pretty much showed what they kind of teased and promised us in a way. Not really promised us, but they teased it. And at the beginning of the showcase, they said, we're not making fucking Battle Royale. And that is very hopeful for me, that they're not going to try and sneak in Battle Royale for Borderlands. Because Borderlands is a cooperative type of, you know, it's a cooperative loot shoot. It pretty much has the looting, like, premise of what Diablo has and everything like that. And that's a freaking ad. Don't try and sneak that into my stream. But, yeah, overall, you know, if they worked on Borderlands 3 for 5 years, then it should be prominent that they really shouldn't have too many problems when it comes to polishing. They're probably going to finish up polishing for the rest of the year. If they plan on releasing it later on this year or next year after that, this should be a good amount of time to just do polish work. Just keep polishing the game. Make sure everything runs smoothly. Make sure your net code is up to date. Everything like that. And we're fucking good to go. I hope to God, I really hope to God, when Borderlands 3 comes out, it doesn't run like absolute shit when you're trying to play online with all your friends. But until then, we have games like Risk of Rain 2 that we can play with other people while we're waiting for Borderlands 2 to come. I mean, 3 to come out, not 2. Borderlands 3 to come out. The remastering of Borderlands 1, in case anyone wants to play through the whole entire series. Now you can play through all the whole entire series with all the DLC with Borderlands 1 remastering and the updated version of Handsome Jack Collection. That way you can play Borderlands 2 and the pre-sequel. Don't forget that Tales from the Borderland is essential to the story because they'll have some of those characters within Borderlands 3. They did say that in the beginning, that some of the characters from Borderlands, Tales from the Borderlands, is going to be in the game. So If you want to get to know those characters, don't forget to play that game as well from Telltale, which is now dead. Then we just have to wait for Borderlands 3 and hope it's not a massive failure. They worked on it for 5 years. I have faith in them that they're not going to screw up Borderlands 3. From what I saw, I love the character designs. The two new big bad guys, they look like brother and sister, maybe. I don't know if they are, but they look interesting. Character designs and all that. You know, they have that same classic dark outlining and outlining in the faces and all that, depending on where you're looking at them and everything. They still have that type of art style. It looks good. And yeah, my favorite Borderlands was Borderlands 2. Borderlands pre-sequel was okay, but it was a little dull after a bit. You know, there's something about Borderlands pre-sequel that didn't really live up to Borderlands 2. Yeah, it was a kind of a smaller game, but at the same time, there were certain mechanics in the game, the pacing of the game, and just a little bit of everything that didn't really work too well with pre-sequel, in my opinion. And I would like to see what they do with the remastering of Borderlands, the first one, because they weren't just touching it up as they were talking about it since we couldn't see it. We'll probably see it on YouTube a little bit later. What's all going on with that remastering. I'm kind of hoping that they clean up some of the gunplay and everything as well, because the gunplay of the first Borderlands wasn't that bad, but it, when you go from Borderlands 1 to 2, there's a huge significant difference when it comes to quality. So yeah, all we have to do is wait for an absolute release date. Hopefully it doesn't come out for early access, just release the game in its full entirety. Make sure you get it done right. Do not, whatever you do, Gearbox, do not fucking do microtransactions in your game unless there's some type of cosmetic thing. That means I don't really have to worry about it. I can just forget about it, and I can play the game the way it is meant to be played. Nothing's locked behind, you know, a paywall. So, yeah. Yeah, and when they, the quality of life stuff for the first Borderlands is going to be nice, because having an actual mini-map in that game would be nice. Because in order to actually figure out where you're going to go in the first Borderlands, you had to like open up your map and figure out, oh, we need to go east. We don't, or east, you know, southeast or something like that. So we had to do that stuff. But overall, I'm excited. You know, I'm a Borderlands fan. I've enjoyed those games. I love just getting endless amount of loot. But the thing that really like screams out to me when it comes to Borderlands is mainly just, you know, the art style, the humor. The humor is not super cringy. Some of it is, but it's cringy in a way to where it still works upon itself, to where they can make fun of themselves. They're very self-aware. Claptrap or some other characters, you know, break fourth wall and stuff like that, and I kind of like it. So yeah, overall I'm excited. There's nothing else to really talk about except that we officially have a Borderlands 3, even though they've been teasing it for years now. We're finally able to officially say that yes, Borderlands 3 is finally coming. We don't know what exact date it is. We might probably see a release date either later on today, a few days from now, or maybe at E3. We don't know yet. But yeah, just keep your ears out. See where the see when the release date is, and until then, I'll keep doing my playthroughs. We might, if anyone gets some of their other projects that they've been working on, some of the other games they're publishing, like Risk of Rain 2, if you guys want to play that on the stream, or just play that casually off stream, that would be an off stream game too if we want. Risk of Rain, if you're a fan of the first game, they made it into a 3D world. I think they were saying like only three dudes have been working on it, but they've been working on it for 3 years. You can now get it for early access, and if you buy your own copy, you will have the ability to get a free copy and gift it to a friend. So that's always an option. For me though, I got a lot on my plate. can't really get the game. Depending on how expensive, you know, Risk of Rain is, and I might not be able to buy it that way. Like, I would like to get it. I would like to get one or two copies so I can just gift $20. Is that the price? Oh boy. Yeah, I don't have $20 to spend. But yeah, I was about to say, if I was able to get two copies, I would give, you know, who would actually be able to play with us, you know, weeks on end, or at least until the point to where it's officially released and all that. So I'm not a very big fan of playing games early access, but I would love to be able to get at least two copies. That way I can give away two copies to you guys. But I don't know. Overall, we'll see. We'll see what happens.